Okay, now we switch gears from oncological imaging and move on to imaging of the paranasal sinuses, which is the bread and butter of most of our ENT practice. And I shall discuss all about the various sinonasal drainage pathways and hence the patterns of chronic sinusitis, which therefore result whenever obstruction to a particular pathway happens. So the sinuses are divided into anterior group of sinuses and the posterior group of sinuses. Anterior sinuses include the frontal sinus, the anterior ethmoidal, and the maxillary sinus, which drain via the osteomedial unit into the middle meatus. Posterior sinuses are the posterior ethmoidal and the sphenoid sinus, which drain via the sphenoethmoidal recess into the superior meatus. So let's begin with understanding of the osteomedial unit. Remember, it's a three-dimensional space. It is not something that is seen on just one coronal image that we may make a mistake of kind of misinterpreting it like that. This is the representative coronal scan, which best delineates most of the components of the osteomedial unit, but it actually is a three-dimensional space, which is the drainage pathway of all those anterior sinuses that we have talked of. So this is the maxillary ostium, which is at the anterior and the superior corner of the maxillary sinus, draining via the ethmoidal infundibulum and the hiatus semilunaris into the middle meatus here. This is the uncinate process, attaching inferiorly to the inferior turbinate, moving superiorly, and this is the bulla ethmoidalis, usually the largest cell of the anterior group of ethmoidal cells. These are our main components of OMU that we are looking at here in this coronal picture. So let's look at these structures in a little bit of detail. Get into the habit of using your crosshair or cursor and using all these three planes, trying to align the structure to the other two planes using this crosshair. It makes life so much more simple. This is the uncinate process as we see it, we are very used to seeing it on the coronal scan, and look at it on the sagittal image. This is the uncinate process, attaching anteriorly to the lacrimal bone, going posteriorly with a free margin posteriorly. Inferiorly, we have seen it attaches to the inferior turbinate, and superior has a variable attachment, and we shall see that later. This is the bulla ethmoidalis, the larger cell here in the anterior ethmoidal group. This is the bulla ethmoidalis on the sagittal image. Learn to start looking at sagittal images. When I was a resident, we used to be looking at only axial and coronal scans, but sagittal plane is the new kid on the block and tells us a lot about these drainage pathways. So this is your bulla ethmoidalis. This is the uncinate process. In between lies the hiatus semilunaris. This here is the hiatus semilunaris between the uncinate and the bulla. So what can encroach the maxillary infundibulum and result in obstructive sinusitis? We can have a large bulla which can obstruct this infundibulum. We can have these cells, the anterior ethmoidal cells, which go into the floor of the orbit. What are these called? Haller cells. Perfect. So these, when large, can obstruct the infundibulum. By definition, these are cells which lie lateral to the lamina papyracea. So lateral to this medial wall of the orbit are the Haller cells. There can be various uncinate variations which can encroach onto the infundibulum. For example, a hooked uncinate which could just turn like this, or a pneumatized uncinate here. Atelectatic uncinate reaching very close to the medial wall of the orbit can result in obstructive sinusitis. In addition, this will also make orbit very prone to injury during your endoscopic procedure. So it's good for a surgeon to know beforehand. It is associated with silent sinus syndrome. We'll also see that in a while. What else can encroach upon the osteomedial unit? We can have this deviated septum with a large spur which can block it. We can have these concha bullosa and the lamellar concha. Lamellar concha not involving the bulbous part of the turbinate. Usually physiologically does not have a physiological impact generally, or we could have a paradoxical curvature of turbinate. We are all very familiar with these variations which we day in and day out on our PNS scans. Certain variations that we may need to be aware of, this is one of them. This is accessory ostium posterior to the OMU, and when present can result in recurrent sinusitis. So the surgeon needs to go ahead and combine the two ostea to prevent this recurrence. So we need to look at this and report this if there's maxillary sinusitis. Infraorbital nerve canal runs in the superior wall of the maxillary sinus or the inferior wall of the orbit. And this at times can be dehiscent into the maxillary sinus. Maxillary sinus may have a septum within. The septa may go on and be attached to this infraorbital nerve. And hence, traction on this septa could injure the nerve if the surgeon is trying to remove that septum. So all these variations are worth reporting in our scans. Lamina papyracea, as we see in the medial wall of the orbit here, should be running in the plane of the maxillary ostium. If it is more medial, that means it will be more prone to injury when the endoscopist, when the surgeon goes in and puts his endoscope here to remove the ethmoidal inflammation, the lamina papyracea may then be more prone to injury. Lamina papyracea may also have certain defects which are normally seen in about 10% of the population. Smaller defects are very, very common. They could be something like this, where we have fat protruding in, but they become more significant as we grow more posteriorly, because now the fat between the medial rectus and the medial wall of the orbit is now much lesser, and hence the chances of orbital injury now increase as the defect is lying more posterior. So it's not only the size of the defect, but also the position of this defect. So let's quickly delineate these main components again. This is your maxillary ostium, this one. Infundibulum, this is the hiatus semilunaris, this is our uncinate process, this is the bulla ethmoidalis, and this is our middle meatus.